What is up, guys? Welcome back to a new Black Ops 4 video. Wow, I haven't said that in such a long time. It feels crazy, man. So, as you guys know, I've just been playing Apex Legends because the game is absolutely amazing. Respawn, let me give you guys a round of applause because that game is freaking amazing. Oh my god, it's amazing, but at the same time, it has ruined my life. Not only did I stop playing Call of Duty, but I've also been playing the game like a motherfucker, and I played so much, I don't even have time to make videos, because when I look at the clock, it's time to go to bed, man. It's time to hit the sack, because I only have like 5 hours left to sleep. So, I sleepwalk all day, and when I get home, I play Apex Legends, and that's pretty much what I do. And I freaking hate my life now, but the game is amazing. What can I say? Like, the game is absolutely biblical. So, oh my god, it is free. So if you're not playing Apex Legends, you're doing something wrong. It is first person, right? It's not a third person shooter like Fortnite, which, you know what, that's why I stopped playing Fortnite pretty much, and also because of the dumb building, like nerds building entire cities in 5 seconds while you just finished putting two ramps down, and you had to sweat like a motherfucker to put two ramps down, and these guys are building skyscrapers, whole cities above you. Oh my god. So I stopped playing Fortnite because of that, and there's nothing of that nonsense in Apex Legends. The game is amazing. I mean, you have, first of all, no silencers, right? So all gunshots are loud. There's no sneaking up from behind with a silencer. I hope they don't put any silencers in the game. Yeah, I love that because the game is more fast-paced. You hear gunshots, you immediately run towards them. There's no freaking going prone. Therefore, there's less camping. I freaking love it. There's no fall damage, so it gives you more freedom to jump down a cliff if you have to. If you're getting shot, you just jump down. You go forward. You don't think about it. You don't think about breaking your ankle like a princess. There's no bullet penetration. Therefore, anything in the map can be used as cover. Therefore, you're taking shots. Boom, you hide behind a tree. You hide behind a freaking, I don't know, what, a bush. You don't get shot through anything, and I love that, because you don't get melted, right? It gives you a chance to fight back, to survive. You can respawn teammates, which is absolutely amazing, as long as there are respawn beacons in the game. As long as your boys get your banner card, it doesn't matter how many times you die, it's not over yet. So I freaking love that. It's pretty fun. There is the game has perfect bullet damage. Like, I freaking love it. It takes a lot of bullets to kill, but I love that because it gives you a chance to either fight back, right? You can turn around and fight back, or you can run for your life and just disappear if you have to. Get your health back up, get your shields back up. You don't get deleted like in Blackout. I've always hated that in Blackout, in Blackout 4. There's a lot of team play in this game, as players have roles, right? You have the medic, you have the tank with the shields, you have the rushers with the smokes and whatever. All players can help each other with their abilities and whatever, which makes the game more fun. It makes the characters more unique, right? The ping system is biblical. You can ping everything on the map, enemies, stuff for your teammates, so you don't need a headset. It makes it it makes the game more fun when you're playing with randoms. The game has great sound, footsteps, gunshots, everything is amazing. And the movement system is biblical. It pretty much feels like Call of Duty, because this game was made by the old Infinity Ward that made Modern Warfare 2 and Call of Duty 4. So the game, it's like you're floating. I love it. And besides the, the movement system being amazing, there's also zip lines that allows you to move faster. There's the grapple, there's the trampolines, whatever it's called, or jump pads. You can fly with the balloons. So there's a lot of crazy stuff in this game, and I love it. So did I stop playing Black Ops 4 because this game is super duper amazing? Well, that's another reason why. Another reason why I stopped playing Black Ops 4 is because it's because Activision freaking sucks, and Treyarch also made a dumb mistake. But first of all, and let me tell you right now, I love Black Ops 4. It is one of my favorite Call of Duty games of all time. I love Black Ops 4 way more than Advanced Warfare, Black Ops 3, Infinite Warfare, and World War 2. So, after Call of Duty Ghosts, I'm gonna have to say that Black Ops 4 is my favorite Call of Duty game. I just freaking love it. I'm talking about the multiplayer, right? The Black Ops 4 is like the whole package. Everything is great. Zombies is great, but I'm not a zombies guy. I kind of suck at it, especially this one. You know, when it comes to zombies, I prefer Black Ops 2. Black Ops 2 is my favorite when it comes to zombies because it's still the good old traditional Call of Duty game, a zombies game, I mean, where you get your perks, you get your wonder weapon from the box and whatever, you kill zombies until you die, until you get bored, whatever. But if you want something more spicy, if you want something more juicy, you can complete the Easter eggs, which can give you another wonder weapon or something like that. And in Black Ops 4 and also Black Ops 3, they made it like super annoying, super boring to play. And it's just not for me because I'm a little Jimmy at zombies. And then there's also Blackout. Blackout is also amazing, but I've realized that, and there's a freaking ambulance just going crazy. You guys can probably hear it right now. Really? Someone had to die right now, or someone had to have a... Oh, okay. That's unfortunate. Anyways, there's also Blackout. I've realized that Blackout is amazing, but the reason why I really enjoyed Blackout was because of the vehicles. As soon as I got bored of the vehicles, I got bored of Blackout. As soon as I got my win with the truck, so I was able to get... of win just road killing people, I was like, you know what, I'm done. They also ruined the truck because, I mean, it makes no sense that a Semtex grenade can insta-kill you when they throw it against the tank. It doesn't make sense that mesh mines can truck. It doesn't make sense that mesh mines can also destroy boats and trucks and stuff like that. And yeah, there's a lot of more annoying stuff in the game that I do not like when it comes to Blackout. And there's a multiplayer. I love it. It is amazing. It kind of feels like a combination between Black Ops 2 and Modern Warfare 2. I don't know what it is. I freaking love this multiplayer. The maps are good. The maps are good. And the maps are amazing. Like, the normal maps are good. Not all of them, but, you know, some of them are nice, enjoyable to play. But then you have the classic maps, which is amazing, like Summit, Firing Range, Jungle, and also Slums. Those games, those maps are amazing because they belong to amazing Call of Duty games. So when you're playing them, it takes you back to the good old days when Call of Duty was amazing, especially Black Ops 1. Like, oh my god, biblical idea. And I love the fact that they brought back the maps the same way they looked in Black Ops 1 and Black Ops 2. And then we have the killstreaks. This game has amazing killstreaks. If you don't count with the dart, with the sentry gun, and with the thresher. I still like the dart, right? The dart is cheeky. If you use it in the halftime of domination, and if you immediately fly towards their base flag, you can get some triples and some quads. I've done it. So the dart is better than the sentry gun and the thresher. But then you have things like the AC-130, which is biblical. It is the best AC-130 in Call of Duty history, because all guns destroy people. Like in MW2, the AC-130 was amazing, but the last gun, the tiny gun, didn't do anything. It was pretty bad. This one destroys people. And then I'm just gonna mention the Sniper's Nest. All the other killstreaks are amazing, but let me mention the Sniper's Nest. This killstreak is amazing. It's like the Harrier. The Harrier was amazing because you could kill people with the airstrike, then the Harrier would hover and get a bunch of kills, and then if any choppers appeared, like Pavlo chopper or attack helicopter, it would destroy them. The Sniper's Nest is at that level. It's a killstreak that does a bunch of things. So you have two elite snipers quick scoping, doing all sorts of trick shots in the helicopter. The sound it makes every time you get a kill with those puppies is amazing. And besides being aimbots, they will also destroy drone squads, mesh mines, freaking canine units. So these guys do a bunch of things, and you know what? I freaking love that. And then we have great guns. This game has great guns, and they are amazing, especially because of the operator mods, which turns these guns into something completely different. Most of them, at least. So it kind of gives the game more variety when it comes to guns. And you know what? I love that. It makes the game super fun. And then we have the specialists. Oh my god, do I love the specialists. Most people hate the game, the multiplayer, because of the specialists. I love the game, the multiplayer, because of the specialists, man. Like, Firebreak. It's not like I'm using a specialist and you're not using a specialist. I mean, you have the choice to use a specialist. So instead of crying about it, just use your specialist. You just gotta be the fastest one to choose the one you want, right? Firebreak is my favorite because of the flamethrower. It is biblical. You can get so many kills with that bad boy. And the pocket nuke, oh my god, the reactor core is biblical. There's also Ajax and Torque. Those are my favorites. And then let me mention another thing. The assists counting as kills. I love that because it doesn't matter if you actually kill them or not. As long as you're putting bullets in their faces, it's gonna count as a kill in the scoreboard. Therefore, in this game, we get way more kills than in other Call of Duty games. So, if I like this game so much, especially the multiplayer, why did I stop playing it? Well, as I said, Apex Legends is amazing and Black Ops 4 got boring after 5 months. And the reason why it got boring, the reason why I stopped playing is is because of the lack of good multiplayer updates. So the multiplayer got boring. I mean, it's pretty much the same as it was 5 months before, right? It's like they're trying to make Blackout their bread and butter when multiplayer used to be that back in the day, right? I mean, multiplayer used to be the main thing. Now they want Blackout to be as big as Fortnite. So they're putting everything they have into Blackout. And they kind of don't give a shit about the multiplayer, man. And that freaking sucks. Because I don't want to play Blackout. Another mistake that Treyarch made that ruined the multiplayer was Zero. Zero was the worst idea of all time. Like, giving players a character that can destroy AC-130s and even steal certain killstreaks, like, what the hell? I'm sweating like a nerd to earn my killstreaks, and then some little Jimmy is gonna steal them by using Zero? That made no sense. And the EMP grenade is also super annoying because it can destroy your stuff, and you know what? I don't like that. It's something I hated back in Black Ops 2, and I also hate that in Black Ops 4. And now I've heard you can use two specialists, like two Zeros in Black Ops 4. Like, what? That's a nightmare. The new DLC system in this game also sucks because you don't have as much content as you had before with the traditional DLC system. So another mistake. And finally, they decided to add supply drops once again to Call of Duty. Of course, they had to milk Black Ops 4 as much as possible. And you know what? I do not support supply drops. I just have one question. Where's the amazing supply drop system from World War 2, from Infinite Warfare, where you could earn your stuff, where you could unlock guns, new guns every single day? You don't have any of that in Black Ops 4, and you know what? That freaking sucks. So that's pretty much it, ladies and gentlemen. Let me know what you guys think in the comment section below. Pretty much I stopped playing Black Ops 4 because it got boring, and I started playing Apex Legends because it is amazing, but I haven't played Black Ops 4 in such a long time that probably it's not boring anymore. It's not gonna be boring for a while, so I might give it a chance again. Thank you for watching. Smack that like button, comment, and subscribe. I'll see you guys next time. Peace out.